we'll look at a new block in Scratch called Broadcast, and it's how we tell another script to run. Check out this short and somewhat uninteresting play that I made, and then we'll talk about how I did it and how you'll be able to make something much cooler. I'll click the green flag to get started. Okay, that's it. Now let's look at the scripts. Remember that both my cat and my duck have their own scripts, so I can click on them and see the different scripts that they have. We can't do this in Scratch, but I'll put them side by side so we can look at how Broadcast works. On the left, I have the scripts from the cat, and on the right, I have the scripts from the duck. The cat's first script starts when the green flag is clicked, and the cat says, "Hello, Mr. Duck," for 2 seconds. Next, what it does is it broadcasts the message, "Duck, turn one." That's like shouting, "Duck, turn one," and anyone listening for that message will know that they should get started. So here, the duck has a corresponding hat block that says, "When I receive, duck, turn one." So that's the same message that this cat is sending. So when the duck receives that message, it will start this script and say, "Hello, cat," for 2 seconds, and say, "How are you?" for 2 seconds. When it's done, it'll broadcast another message. That message is cat turn one. So that's like saying, "Cat turn one!" And anyone that's listening for that message will hear it and be able to start their script. We can see here that the cat has a hat block listening for that message. It says, "When I receive cat turn one." So whenever someone broadcasts cat turn one, this script will start. And it will say, "I'm fine, thank you. How are you?" When it's done, after it finishes saying that, it'll broadcast duck turn two. Duck turn two is another message, and we can see that the duck is listening for that message. "When I receive duck turn two," and it'll say, "Good, thanks." So by using broadcast, we're effectively telling the other script to start running. The text of this message doesn't matter to Scratch. It's really for us humans to be able to read. This could say broadcast X, A, B, C, D, E. And as long as this one had the exact same message, it would still start that script. So it doesn't matter exactly that we used the word duck or turn one. Those were for us as humans to be able to keep track of. Now let's look at how to create one of these messages. Here I am in Scratch and I want to make a new broadcast message. I can click on events and it has a default one for me, "When I receive message one" or "Broadcast message one." So here, if I drag out broadcast message one and "When I receive message one," I'll put a meow sound after the "When I receive message one." So here, when I double click on broadcast message one, that will start this "When I receive message one" script running, and we should hear the meow sound. Let's listen. Cool. Remember, the text of this message doesn't matter to the computer, but it's helpful if we make it make sense. So I can create a new message which says "Play meow." And now I can switch this to say "Play meow." And now when I double click on it, it'll do exactly the same thing. If I have a bug where I broadcast "Play meow," but this one's only listening to receive message one, if I double click on this broadcast, we won't hear anything. See? So only if it's listening for the exact right message. And you can see here, we can have two hat blocks that receive the message "Play meow." This one will play meow, and this one will play a note 60. We should be able to hear both of them when we double click on this script. Could you hear them both? So a broadcast works to tell another script or many scripts to start playing. It's going to be really helpful to make plays and other animations.